down on also on my left below my flat files here, my reference files, is my all-present sketchbook, which I use for everything under the sun. This is log 28, meaning that I have 28 of these books right here. This is a hardbound right here. I tend to be abusive to them at times, so they need to have a good hardcover on them. The size is 11 by 14 of these pages here. That's kind of the way the books start out. I've been making a lot of notations in these books, a lot more than I used to. My first sketchbook started out as a bunch of scribbles, pretty much, when I was about 18. And that was back in 1977, 75 maybe, 76. And now it's 2011, and I'm not 18 anymore, I'm 54. So I started this sketchbook off with a memory sketch of my backyard. It was sprinkling outside, and I thought, well, geez, how do I capture those sparkling water drops on the grass? And I don't know if I did it or not, but you can see a lot of notes that I used myself. It's kind of like using myself as my teacher, since I'm the only one available to teach myself at times. A lot of studies. There's a baby skull right there. I was trying to figure out how babies work. These are some ideas that I had for some of the models that come into my studio. A lot of these end up being aborted because the models prove to be so flaky that they never actually get done. But the ideas are here, recorded forever, in case I ever need to refer back to them for maybe finding someone who's actually reliable. A lot of quotes right here that I pasted in from the last sketchbook, number 27. Okay, what do we have here? More notes. Jester drawings. That's from Kirby, I'm sure. There's my gorgeous princess, Gino Janelli. There's Gino's eyes. Who is this from? Robert Fawcett. I saw a drawing that he did and copied it, made a copy of it, put it in my sketchbook for reference, and then redrew the folds on the right there. That's Daphne, isn't it? The girl from, what's his name? The guy that walked out on Disney. Bluth, yeah. Okay. More notes on Sargent. I don't know what that's from right there, but... eye studies. There's a little study right there of flowers. Oh, that's a cutout. Never mind. But I like the way it was done, so... drew a newspaper right here. Kind of a neat idea. Working on my pen and ink technique right there. These are things that I warm up with in the morning. There's a drawing in charcoal on newsprint paper, and I cut it out and paste it in there just for something different. Working on my eyes, gestures. Painting made easy, two things. Hey, I should write a book. a page of Kirby musculature. Always fascinating for me to study. And what do we have over here? Some more Kirby stuff. A lot of things that you see here are things that I do in the very beginning of the day. I warm up with them in the morning. Oh, there's my favorite captain right there. The good Captain Kirk. A drawing of some girl with lighting on her back. A certain way that I liked. Working with some caricatured stuff. Caricature is a great way to figure out realistic drawing, because it's realistic drawing reduced to very cursive sweeps of the pencil. These are pasted in copies of one of my favorite artists. His name is Walter Biggs. And these drawings right here in green were done from one of the Dr. Solar books that Mike Richardson from Dark Horse sent me. I didn't like the gestures that the artist actually drew in the book, so I redid my own. And these are good mind exercises right here. Studies of bodies, all that kind of stuff. We'll pull way back here and see what I've got going on here. Just more drawings. Just always trying to figure things out. That was the way I approached everything when I was 18. Or actually, much earlier than that. Just trying to figure things out. And I loved to draw from other artists. I loved to copy their ideas and see if I could draw them. even remotely as good. That was from a Space Ghost layout right there. I'm always thrilled when I find these original layouts, and a lot of times I like to do my version of them to see if I can make them better or improve on them in any way at all. Here's a baby's head. Most artists are very weak on babies, and they have a structure to their head like everyone else does, and you just got to know what that is. Here's a caricature drawing of a girl's body that was actually a very realistic drawing at first, and I converted it into what I call caricature, or the animated version of something real. Just imagine if you took, you know, a photograph of somebody, or you had something from life in front of you, and you reduced it to an animated version of that. Say, like when Disney caricatures a real actor who's doing the voice for their character. You know, they turned Whoopi Goldberg into a damn hyena, so, you know, anything is possible. I was in love with Cinderella for a little bit there, so I started to draw things from that because, I don't know, I just liked doing it. It was fun. Just working out some more ideas down there. Light and shadow. I think that's Iron Man right there. Another idea for a model that I had who never showed up. Hair practice with paint. What else do we have here? Oh, I was trying to work out the new arrangement for my painting area right here, which we'll show you in a little bit. You know, so that's kind of what we're looking at here. Head practice. This is cool. I would put on a videotape of the Herculoids, and I would see some of the drawings that the layout artists had done before they animated them, and some of them were very weak, and of course that drives me crazy, so I have to come up here and do my own version of how I wish they would have done it. There's another model idea that I don't know, I'm not sure where that came from. That's from John Legata, another famous artist that I like. Here's more studies. See the glass sunglasses in the girl's mouth. That was a study I did for a commission that I was doing of Gwen Stacy, and I wanted her to be nibbling on the end of her glasses. I think that's from a mirror right there. I use myself as just about anybody in a mirror, so I can figure out what they look like. Here's more Herculoid stuff. I'm sure that was from a very questionably drawn layout from the Herculoids. More ideas from Toth model sheets. These great creatures he thought up that I draw. I guess I'm trying to assimilate them in my head when I draw them. You know, so there's Kirby. This is a whole amalgamation of stuff that I like right here. There's Toth and Kirby right next to each other. Had to draw somebody with a boot on for one of my paintings, so I did a study. I grabbed one of Janelle's boots and hauled it out and did a study of it. Figuring out lighting. I thought we might revive the moth for a second there, so I was trying to organize all the pages that we had that were half done, and some were done, and some were just sketched in, and all that kind of stuff. Oh, here's ideas for the Batman cover I did for my most recent sketchbook. Ideas. What do mouths look like when they open up real wide? Well, I was just trying to find out there. There's a Loomis girl right there.